What's up, these snakes? We're back to another video on the Flash comic series. Guys, this is actually Flash number 554. So this is actually the penultimate chapter in this Flash Age storyline. And guys, I'm all prepared for it. I finally got my Flash shirt for all the videos that I do on for the Flash TV show when it eventually returns like next year. And the comic series. Now guys, if you haven't heard yet, pretty much Joshua Williams, the guy who writes the series, will actually be ending his run in like two story arcs. So we have this story arc, which is the Flash Age, which will end next issue. Then we have Legion of Zoom, which will be like Flash against like Gorilla Grodd, all these different Flash rogues. And then we'll have, after that, will be pretty much a final storyline called Finish Line. I'm pretty sure it's gonna end on issue number 761, or somewhere around that, so it's not that far off, guys. Like, there's not a lot of issues left, but I'm pretty sure there could be some awesome issues, because by his Twitter post, you can check out his Twitter, guys. I'll link in the description below, but it pretty much shows that he showed some images, like covers for upcoming issues, and it's gonna be a big end to the series. Like, overall, his entire storyline would be 101 issues. Now, that's actually kind of what Tom King was trying to aim for with his Batman series. He was trying to go for like 105 issues. But the problem with Tom King's run was he had so much filler after the whole wedding issue. Like, there's so much filler, and it was like, wait, why is this going to be 100 issues? So they just cut it down to 85. Where this whole entire run, like, pretty much most of it has been non-filler. Like, there's been a bunch of big storylines after another. We had the origin story, we had the Flash War, we had all such a cool, like, so much cool stuff. And coming into this storyline, the Flash Age, which started out in issue number 750, which is a big milestone issue, it's been really good. And finally, in this issue, we see Barry and Reverse Flash, Gabar Thong, team up to pretty much fight off and get rid of Paradox, the big, like, Flash villain. He's like a new Flash villain. And that's pretty much what this issue is based off of. Now, before we get into the issue, if you haven't liked the video, give a big thumbs up, new channel, make sure to subscribe so you miss my next Flash comic review. I go over all the ones every 2 weeks they come out, and I'm super excited for the next one, the finale to this big story arc. But guys, pretty much in this issue, what we see, it starts out, and you see that, okay, Paradox was a big threat in the future, he's taking down all these people, he took down, like, pretty much the rogues in the future, which I forgot their name, but they're pretty much, they help out, they're not actually really villains. Like, you have Commander Cold, all these different, rogues that are now heroes in a way, like, they help out with, like, the police force. But they're taking down all the citizens. Pretty much Central City is a wreck. And then we have Reverse Flash, and he's now the new savior. And you hear him just monologuing this. And he's telling this all to Barry. He's like, everybody was gonna die, everything was going to chaos. But then I showed up. And finally people saw me as what I always wanted them to see me as. Pretty much like the new Flash. Like, pretty much somebody who's saving people. Like, that's actually what Gabar Thong wanted. He always looked up to Barry. Well, not Barry, looked up to the Flash. And wanted to pretty much become that new hero in the future. But it didn't go well because he pretty much put people's lives in danger so he could save them. So every time he did save them, in a way, he murdered them because he caused that incident. But in this case, he was actually a hero. He saved Central City, beat Paradox, he put him into like the Flash Museum in like a pretty much cage that he couldn't get out of. Paradox couldn't use his powers. And he pretty much used all that stuff because he went through the history of Paradox. He did a lot of things and used this thing called Lightning Rod to make him faster and to beat Paradox. It's a really cool thing. It's a great intro. And we see Barry and he's monologuing to himself in his like captions. And he's like, alright, so but Reverse Flash does not remember. There's actually an Gabar Thong from like the future that doesn't know that Iris kills him. Does not know about Flashpoint and does not know about all the big Flash history. That's what Barry thinks. But then Reverse Flash actually tells him later on that, yeah, I read through my own history. I know that I died so many times. And this is not going to go wrong again. We have to team up. We have to do this right. We got to be Paradox. And then we can be pretty much enemies afterwards. But what we see is Barry's like, alright, I'll follow you. You're the one being before, so you got to help me out. We'll do this. But in the midst of all this, we see pretty much Paradox with Godspeed. Godspeed's just running. He's just doing what Paradox says because he can't fight him off. Paradox is too powerful. And we see Paradox going through all these different timelines, like points in time, and killing all these Barrys. Like, well, all these flashes, and it's pretty much just all buried throughout the timeline. And we see him actually go to the point where pretty much where Jake Yarrick and Barry Allen met, that big famous image where they're running alongside and somebody's like calling for help to the Flash, but it's both of them coming. Like, that's a really famous image. But we see that, and we see Jake Yarrick on the ground, his helmet's off, he's beat up. We see Godspeed, he's beat up, and Paradox holds like the Flash right there and just kills him. So he's killing all these different Flashes because he's trying to base off the idea that, hey, if I kill all these Flashes off, it'll destroy the Flash legacy. But then he notices, I'm taking this the wrong approach. I gotta take a more newer approach. And the approach he takes is, alright, what about I go back to the beginning? Pretty much go and pretty much destroy myself. So I get rid of like pretty much that part of myself that pretty much prevents me from doing what I could do. He's like, then I can just go full on, just kill the Flash, take down his legacy, and try his whole goal, because pretty much the Flash ruined his life. So he wants to get revenge. That's pretty much like the basic ideal that Paradox is going by. But guys, what happens next is the awesome part in this issue is Barry in Reverse Flash, right? And Barry's like, alright, what are we gonna do? Why are we back here in the past? Who's this one guy? And the guy they're talking about is actually Paradox, before he came Paradox. Who's his family? What are we doing here? And Eobard Thunk's like, have you not figured out yet? We're here to kill that guy. We're here to kill him so he doesn't become a problem later on. And Barry is like, no, I'm not gonna do that. I'm not killing this guy. Like, that's wrong. Like, the whole reason, like, he pretty much assumes this, the whole reason that he became Paradox is because Flash ruined his life. So the way to stop is by killing him? Like, is that really right? But for me, I think it's a good idea. Like, alright, it's not gonna kill people. Come on. This guy's about to become Paradox. And yeah, it could cause some problems, because the same thing is, it actually is kind of similar to Flashpoint. Like, going back in time to save Nora, but this time, going back in time and killing somebody. So it's kind of opposite, but still should cause, like, a ripple in the timeline. But it's kind of better than having Paradox. You gotta take it with a grain of salt. It's alright. So if I kill Paradox, or before he became Paradox, there's no problem with that. But it could cause other problems in the future. So it's kind of a hard choice. But then we see Reverse Flash just like, alright, I'll do it myself. He goes to kill the guy who becomes Paradox, which I forgot his name, his actual name. Like, it's not really that memorable. Like, Paradox is memorable, that name is memorable, not the actual human name. But we see this and they're fighting. Barry's like, no, you're not gonna do it. It's an awesome fight. The art in this issue looks amazing, guys. And then we see Paradox shows up and he kills himself, pretty much, like his older self. And Barry's like, no, that's not supposed to happen. And Godspeed's like, Flash will beat you, Paradox. And Paradox's like, nah, there's no hope left. That's not gonna happen. And then what Paradox does, at the end of the issue, he releases all his energy out. He's like, alright, so if I can't kill the Flash, I'm gonna do a whole nother way of doing this. I'm gonna kill everyone that he loves. And he releases all his energy, everything, the timeline is just getting erased. And Reverse Flash is like, alright, it's either we kill Paradox or everything will be gone. Everything will be gone out of existence. And we see Barry just trying to contemplate this, like, what do I do? And that's where the issue ends. That's where it ends. They're both face to face with Paradox. Paradox is huge. The timeline is getting destroyed, everything getting erased. And Barry's just left to like wonder, what am I gonna do? Like, should I kill him? Like, I think he should, like, come on. He's destroying the entire timeline. It's like, it comes a point like you have to do it, or all these people are gonna die, and all the people you love will die. So I really like that. That was good. Reverse Flash was great in this issue. Like, the part when he said, hey, we're here to kill him, to kill Paradox, I was like, no shit. Like, that makes sense. That goes with his character. Paradox, he's actually kind of a better villain. Like, at the end when he just says, oh, I'm just gonna kill everyone you love, that's kind of cliche. Like, I've seen that with so many villains. Well, I'm still going to accept him. So I do like see him go through the timeline, kill all these different Flashes. Like, that was pretty dope. And yes, Godspeed, he's cool. He has some little part, not a lot. There's no Iris. There's no really, like, there wasn't a lot of characters in this issue. It was just Reverse Flash, Flash, Godspeed, and Paradox. Yeah, you say, oh yeah, Jake Yarrick, what about all these other characters? No, it was more like, alright, they're in the background. They didn't really have any dialogue, so I don't count them as actual, like, characters in the story right now. They're more just like, alright, that's cool nostalgia, that's a cool Easter egg. Not like, oh, they're a part in the story, like an important part. But yeah, guys, overall, an awesome penultimate issue to this storyline. I'm excited for the next one, and I'm gonna give this issue an 8.5 out of 10. I definitely recommend it. Go check it out. It's out right now. I'll have my Justice League review out by tomorrow. Yeah, I'll have it out by tomorrow, alright? It'll be Justice League number 45. That should be a pretty good issue. But I wanted to get this review out first, because this issue is just so good. Like, I really like this one. This just really is fast paced, the tension was high. Reverse Flash and Flash Teamup is always awesome. Like, if you're a big Flash fan, you know that's dope and you know it's great. And yeah, I'm excited to see how it's gonna wrap up and actually how Joshua Williams starts to bring his whole run, this big run from issue number one of Rebirth back in 2016 to a conclusion. Like, it's crazy how far we came with this series. But guys, in the comments below, tell me about this issue. Did you love it? Did you hate it? What do you think about the Flash Reverse Flash team up? What do you think about Paradox as a villain? And how you think this whole storyline will wrap up in like 2 weeks? But guys, if you like the video, give big thumbs up on YouTube. Make sure to subscribe so you miss out on my next Flash comic review. And yeah, guys, thanks for watching and peace out.